Here we'll show you how to use Winner Micro W600 Tiny R602 board with OpenBeacon to create a simple IoT device that is compatible with Home Assistant. First, we will start with a simple relay and button control, but then we will also show you how to connect a DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor. Here is the R602 board with USB breakout that we are going to use. This board has a few I/O pins available, but it will be enough for us. Let's start by soldering the gold pins header so we can plug the Wi-Fi module into the proto board. First, insert gold pins into the PCB and then add some flux. Flux is very helpful and makes soldering much easier. Finally, solder each gold pin one by one, by first heating up the gold pin and pad, and then by applying solder to each pad. Also, please keep in mind that you should keep your soldering iron tip clean and do not use too high temperature. Use proper temperature for the type of solder you have, and remember, it's easier to solder with the leaded solder. Now you can easily plug your Wi-Fi module to the proto board. Let's start with doing a blink LED example with OpenBeacon. First, prepare the LED circuit. A resistor here is necessary to limit the current. A 200 ohms one should be enough. Then, we need to burn the OpenBeacon firmware to the board. First, it must be done via USB cable, then you can do updates via Wi-Fi. Connect the board to your PC. Download the WM tool and OpenBeacon binary from Winner Micro W600 platform. Links are in the video description. Then use WM tool to flash the binary. Remember to change COM port index to index of your port. Also change the source file name if needed. First, start flash write, then press reset button on the board. The flashing should start, wait for it to finish. Then, finally press reset button again to start the new firmware. Keep in mind that you can use the same approach to flash IoT devices that are using the W600 chip. This method is not limited only to the W600 dev board. OpenBeacon access point should appear. Now we will pair OpenBeacon with your Wi-Fi. Connect the OBK access point and then open the configuration page, see IP address on the screen. Go to Wi-Fi config, enter your Wi-Fi SSID and password, so OpenBeacon device can join your network. Then, finally, you can find out new IP that was assigned to your device in your router DHCP clients page. Okay, OpenBeacon is now flashed to your board and paired with your Wi-Fi. Now it's time to set up the LED. Go to Config Module tab, select the GPIO you have chosen for LED, and choose LED or relay role. OpenBeacon will automatically show a button on its main panel that can control the LED. Remember, you can also script that LED behavior and control it via HTTP command and via Tasmuta control application, and also via MQTT. Now let's add a button. Button can be easily connected between GPIO and ground. No pull-up resistor is needed, because this module has internal programmable pull-ups. Again, go to Configure Module tab and select button role for your chosen GPIO. Remember, the second field with zero index is a channel number. It allows you to group together multiple buttons and LEDs or relays. If you want the button to react on initial press and not after the click release, please also go to Flux and enable instant button reaction. Okay, as you can see, the button is working and controls the LED. The button events can be also scripted, so you can use button to send HTTP GET request or to do a custom MQTT publish. Now we will do something a bit more advanced. First, we need to get a 3.3 voltage connection. This board has no 3.3 volt connection, so we need to solder extra wire to the 3.3 volt pad with capacitor of the Wi-Fi module. Just add some flux, thin the wire and solder it carefully. Remember, the low dropout regulator on board can't provide much current. Please consider using external LDO if you need higher current capability. Now we can connect the DHT11 humidity and temperature sensor. You can see its pinout on the screen. Just connect power to 3.3 volt, ground to ground and data to GPIO of your choice. Then, in Open Beacon Configure Module tab, select the DHT11 role of given GPIO. Save and then also select channels used to store temperature and humidity data. Let's say that we will store temperature in first channel and humidity in the second one. That's all. Now you should get correct readings from your DHT. It's time for a final test. Let's heat up the DHT sensor with a strong flashlight. As you can see, the temperature goes up. It means that DHT sensor is definitely working. Now you can also do a home assistant discovery and receive those readings in HAS, but we already have a video about that. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please visit our forum. You can also consider visiting our IoT devices turn-offs list or even submit a new device there. We can send you a free gift for that. See you on Electroda!